Hi everyone, welcome back to a new term. I hope you managed to have a good break over Easter at home with your families and managed to do lots of fun things together. Easter felt very strange for us this year. Normally we'd go to church on Easter Day and join in with members of Croydon Minster for a joyful Easter service, followed by refreshments and lots of activities involving eggs. Egg painting, egg rolling, an Easter egg hunt, and of course, lots of chocolate. This year, it was very different, yet in some ways, even more special than normal. We all got up very early on Easter Day before dawn. We went outside into the garden where we had made an Easter garden and a wooden cross from the remains of our Christmas tree. We lit an Easter fire in our barbecue and joined in with the dawn service that was being live streamed. As we sat outside, we could hear the dawn chorus as the sky was gradually getting lighter. Even though we were apart from the rest of the congregation, we still felt connected with everyone via the internet and really enjoyed listening to the birds and their wonderful singing, which hopefully you can hear now in the background. Later, we had some fun together in the garden with an Easter egg hunt and decorated some eggs and rolled them down the garden path. We also played badminton in the garden. In fact, I managed to lose some of the shuttlecocks by hitting them over the fence. However, James, my future son-in-law, came to the rescue by making some very effective homemade ones out of a bottle top, which worked even better than the original ones. I hope you all managed to find some fun ways to celebrate Easter together. Please let your teachers know what you did over Easter, and hopefully we can share some of these together on the school website. Often during the Easter break, we go on journeys to visit family and friends, or perhaps go away on holiday together. These can take us to distant places or to other parts of the country. Normally, as a family, we go to visit relatives in North Yorkshire and enjoy some lovely walks in the countryside. This year has been very different, and the furthest that most of us have travelled, I suspect, is the local park, or in our case, Whitgift School grounds. Even though we haven't been able to go far this year, I hope those journeys we have made have been enjoyable, whether for daily exercise or for rest and relaxation. One of the things that I've noticed as I've done my daily walk around the grounds of Whitgift School is that I've started seeing things that I'd missed before. Little things, subtle changes that we so often miss as we tend to rush around during the school day, not seeing the beauty of the world around us. Every day, I notice that things are slightly different. More flowers have come out. The light has changed. More birds are singing. The seasons are slowly changing all around me. When I was a student at Durham, training to be a priest, I used to go on retreat to a beautiful monastery on the coast near Alnwick in Northumbria. While I was there, I often got advice from one of the monks. I remember being told a very helpful thing once, which has stuck with me ever since: the importance of being attentive to everything that is around us, however small or insignificant it might appear. So, for example, when I go on a walk, I try to be quiet and attentive to what's going on around me, to look out for interesting or unusual things that I can see, to listen carefully for the sound of birds or trees rustling in the wind, to smell the different scents of flowers, and to give thanks for all that the natural world has to say to us and to teach us. If you listen carefully, you can hear the birds singing in the background now as I'm recording this talk. I would encourage you all to do the same and to take a notebook or sketchbook and pen or pencil with you when you go for a walk next. To take note of what you see and hear and to reflect on it. We don't always have to travel to distant places to learn new things. There is so much to see here on our doorsteps. This time of lockdown gives us a wonderful opportunity to appreciate the natural world in our gardens or in our local park that we so often miss. So enjoy it while you can. Learn from it. Become more attentive to the natural world. And be thankful for the small things in life that can brighten up our days. I end with some lovely images of nature from our garden and from my daily walks to uplift you and hopefully encourage you at this time. And after that, we will listen to the song, You'll Never Walk Alone, which reminds us that if we have hope in our hearts, we will never be truly alone. Keep well and keep safe.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm, there's a golden sky and sweet to the song of the lark.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark.
At the end of the storm, there's a golden sky and a sweet silver song of the lark.
Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on, walk on, walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll
your heart, and you'll never walk.